uncle felt that your beard looks like a Muslim beard, and we don't want you to get caught. You better be clean shaven. At least you'll have some safety when you're driving. So trust me, I entered Kanpur, which is from 80 kilometers. Lucknow is 80 kilometers. And as I entered Kanpur, I was told by a policeman not to go to the city. So I told him I cannot return back because obviously there's a lot of risk. So I somehow dodged him and entered the city. So between the entry point of the city and my home, there were about 4 kilometers. And those 4 kilometers were hell. I mean, it was like violence had spread all over. Seemingly natural, normal people were caught by some frenzy. And you could hear bomb blast and you could hear firing and fire. How are these same people able to do violence? Violence is any aggressiveness or rage or physical or verbal which decimates the other person, either in the ego or physical body, especially when there are other alternatives available of a peaceful negotiation. So the secular for Buddha also and Gandhi also meant that I respect your difference. I respect the diversity. Not tolerate, please. I mean, there's a huge difference between these two words. You understand that?
That's
most
right.
Of us know it. When I say I will tolerate, I'm already putting myself on the pedestal and say you are nothing. So I will tolerate. While you respect, you say, okay, I'm giving part of myself. You give part of yourself and let us come to a middle ground. That was the real philosophy of this country. Given that, and they knew, they were great cognitive psychologists without naming psychology, that brain will categorize, brain will always try to look into the gaps. These gaps are where violence arises. What can be and what is. To be human is to live in contradictions. I will not call it a battle, but brain has contradictions. And the way we understand neuroscience, Rajni, today is that larger part of the brain is unconscious. Conscious brain tends to know only what the unconscious brain is throwing at the conscious. And the conscious brain is trying to make a story of it. That is one way of understanding. Everybody has missed out something very important. That is what I think. And they have missed out the process of the man called Mahatma Gandhi. They have really missed out. When we talk of Gandhi, we start talking about his politics, his Gram Panchayat, all that political work which he was doing. But trust me, some point of time, we have to really go back and look at the man. But I started studying Gandhi because I was studying something else actually. I suddenly realized that between 1850 to 1950, especially 1900 to 1950, there was no sphere of human endeavor which was left unturned. Quantum physics toppled Newtonian world. Einstein did this thing. But the greatest experiment we have forgotten. Non-violence and violence were being played on the canvas of the world at the same time in two parallel streams. Mr. Adolf Hitler was epitomizing violence, systematic violence.
Cold-blooded violence, no rage.
Cold-blooded, systematic violence. Mahatma Gandhi was systematizing non-violence. So what was Gandhiji doing? He, Mir Alam hits him. Gandhiji gets out of his coma or unconscious state. First thing he does is, where is Mir Alam? He doesn't allow him to get arrested and all. Mir Alam comes and offers an apology. Gandhiji, and Rajni, this one sentence defines this man. He says, when you were hitting me, my worry was not that I will die, or my worry was I should not hate you at that time. Now we know what contradictions are. Somebody is hitting you, your mind is actually going into that fear, and you are not bothered about that fear. You are bothered that cognitively I should not hate this person. Right? Second incident is when he's walking with Millie Polak. He suddenly jumps to the other side. He talks to somebody. That man gives him something. He comes back. Millie said, what? He says, no, this man had taken a vow that he will kill me. Where will he go finding me? So he's here. So I go. He said, what did you bring? He said, he gave me the knife which he... In Champaran, when all this has started, some commissioner said that I'll kill that, whatever he used a slang for Gandhi. So one day, Mahadev Desai has written this. So one day, Mahadev Desai, by that time, he had become a secretary of Gandhi. So Gandhi at 4:30 in the morning went out. So Mahadev Desai said, where is he going? He goes there. So he goes to the commissioner's house, rings the bell, and said that you told yesterday people that you will kill me whenever you see me. After 7:30 or sometime I become very busy and a lot of people, you will not be able to kill me. So this is 4:30, nobody is seeing. I mean, commissioner could have killed him, huh? Please. That was British Raj, huh? Nothing would have stopped him. And this man says, what? I see this as a quantum jump in the head. Jumping over the fear of death. Something what Buddha did in his life. After sacrificing his body. Now, once Gandhiji was out of this fear, then what remained? He became a master of empathy.